Let's learn about clownfish. You may recognize these striped fish from the popular Disney movie Finding Nemo. Nemo and his dad Marlin are both a part of the fish family called clownfish. Join us as we travel under the sea to learn about the majestic world of clownfish. Fact number one. Clownfish eat plants and meat, spending their days snacking on various types of plankton, algae, shrimp, and worms. Omnivores are animals that eat both vegetarian and other animals. Aquariums that house clownfish will feed them algae and a variety of fish pellets that contain the nutrients required to keep clownfish healthy and happy. Clownfish in the wild primarily feed on bottom-dwelling sea life smaller than they are. Interestingly, clownfish will attract larger fish to the poisonous tentacles of the anemones they call home. Once the fish falls prey to the tentacles, the anemone will consume most of the large fish and leave the leftover scraps to the community of clownfish residing within. Fact number two, clownfish are all born as males. Interestingly, clownfish are all born male. When a clownfish reaches adulthood, it can change into a female to become the only one in a group of clownfish. The female will then lay eggs in their chosen place, and a male will be the primary caretaker of the eggs, monitoring and protecting them from other predators. When the only female clownfish dies, the strongest male will then change into the new female and continue the job of laying eggs. Fact number three, clownfish are also known as anemone. Due to their love of anemones, clownfish are often called anemonefish. This is because clownfish are the only species able to safely use anemones as habits. Anemones have poisonous tentacles that are used to trap fish from the anemone to eat. Scientists have developed theories indicating that clownfish are covered in protective film that allows them to live inside of an anemone without being affected by their poisonous tentacles. You may remember from Finding Nemo that Marlin and his son lived in a gorgeous anemone home. Bonus fact, clownfish are known to feed on dead anemone tentacles as part of their regular diets. Fact number four, clownfish have specific habits. Clownfish can be found living in the warm, shallow waters of the Red Sea, Indian Ocean, and the Pacific Ocean, spending their days traveling through colorful lagoons and coral reefs. As we mentioned earlier, clownfish enjoy living in anemones and benefit from their protection from other species of fish due to the poisonous tentacles of anemones. As pet fish, clownfish need to live in a warm, saltwater aquarium with plenty of areas for them to hide. A clownfish aquarium needs to have high-quality filtration systems, making them harder to care for than other popular fish kept as pets. Quite unlike Nemo and Marlin, clownfish in the wild typically will not wander too far away from their anemone home. In fact, clownfish can be caught spending their days darting in and out of the sea above their anemone home to catch food. Clownfish enjoy hunkering down into the tentacles of their anemones to spend their nights cuddled and warm. Fact number five, clownfish have surprisingly long lives in the wild. Clownfish can live from 6 to 10 years in the wild. Impressive for such a small fish. As pets, these stripy guys can live for 3 to 5 years, which is a surprisingly lowered lifespan. However, if an owner provides them with stellar care, clownfish can live for up to 20 years as pets. If you are interested in owning your very own Nemo, learning the care requirements is extremely important. Adult clownfish need to be fed twice a day, while young clownfish need to be fed 3 to 4 times a day. The remaining food should be cleaned from the tank after each feeding to keep the water clean and fresh. The tank will need to be cleaned consistently, the water replaced regularly, and the filters changed as needed. Fact number six. Female clownfish can lay up to 1,000 eggs. When a male clownfish becomes the female in charge, she can lay up to 1,000 eggs in an anemone at a time. Interestingly, clownfish eggs can hatch at any time of the year, unlike other marine animals. As we mentioned previously, once a female lays her eggs, the male clownfish then takes on the job of protecting and defending the eggs from predators. Clownfish eggs hatch within 6 to 8 days of being hatched. Then the female clownfish will lay another batch of eggs 10 to 14 days after laying the first. Once the eggs have hatched into little baby clownfish, the male and female no longer take care of them. The babies are left to figure out life as a marine animal on their own. With luck, these babies will go on to live for up to 10 years. Number 7. Clownfish can communicate with others. clownfish have developed their own interesting way of communicating with the others in their communities. Using various clicking, chirping, and popping noises, they can accurately communicate with potential mates and potential intruders. These interesting fish create noises by clicking their teeth and mouth bones. Scientists have been able to understand how clownfish communicate through years of research and monitoring them in their warm ocean habits. Fact number 8. Clownfish are very social. Scientists and marine biologists have discovered that clownfish are extremely social animals within groups of the same species. They create communities of various clownfish with specific roles. There will always be one male and female clownfish in charge, with countless other smaller clownfish. When a female dies, the male in charge will then change into a female, while a new male clownfish claims his position as the new male in charge. Clownfish communities will generally live in the same anemone, so their groups cannot be too large in size. They also create tight-knit bonds with their mates. Fact number 9. Clownfish get their names from their unique color patterns. Clownfish have orange, white, and black striped color patterns that remind people of clowns, hence their names. Clownfish are also known to have curious, creative, bold, friendly, and high-energy personalities, and can be found zipping through their habitats in search of food and potential predators. They also have been described as aggressive to potential predators invading their habitats and in defense of the eggs. Males are in charge of protecting. As part of the clownfish community, there will be some fish that prefer to live a calm life, follow the leaders of the community, and not taking charge. Fact number 10. There are 30 types of clownfish. In the wild, up to 30 types of clownfish have been discovered with an extremely wide variety of color patterns. However, individuals interested in owning clownfish should know that they can be aggressive to the various types of clownfish and should instead be housed with fish of the same species. Clownfish species can come in color patterns similar to cow prints, maroon and white stripes, orange and black stripes, and a translucent pink, to name a few. Fact number 10. Clownfish are not great at swimming. Because they spend so much time in their preferred homes of anemones, clownfish are not strong swimmers. As we discussed before, clownfish prefer to spend most of their time in anemones, only leaving to quickly dart to the surface of the anemone to gather food. If a clownfish has to venture far out of an anemone, it will swim in very wild and erratic patterns to evade any potential predators lurking around. Clownfish benefit their anemone homes by protecting them from predators and harmful parasites. Male clownfish are oftentimes left in charge of keeping the anemone fresh and clean for the community. Fact number 12. Clownfish rely on coral reefs. As we know now, clownfish prefer to spend their lives in homes made of anemones. Anemones are a part of the coral reefs that we know and love. Clownfish rely on coral reefs for a reliable habitat that helps to keep their eggs and communities safe from potential predators. In return, clownfish keep coral reefs clean and protect them from potentially harmful parasites. Interestingly, clownfish have developed a way to protect themselves from the poisonous tentacles of anemones. It's easy to see that without coral reefs, clownfish communities would no longer be able to thrive. However, the world's coral reef population is at risk due to the increasing levels of pollution in our oceans. As pets, clownfish benefit from having coral reefs in their aquariums and enjoy spending their days darting through coral and relaxing in their favorite hiding spots. As we have learned, clownfish are an interesting species of fish with bright, eye-catching color patterns and interesting personalities. What is your favorite thing about clownfish? Leave a comment below. We hope you have enjoyed learning about the beautiful and majestic underwater world of clownfish, and cannot wait to take a new learning journey with you. Please don't forget to like the video, subscribe, and join us on our next educational journey.